School shootings have been in the news a lot lately, and many people are wondering, what is Red Rocks Community College doing to protect students and staff in case a shooting were to happen here?
Red Rocks Community College is not a gun-free zone. Students and faculty with a Colorado concealed weapons permit can carry guns as long as they're concealed. Many do carry concealed weapons on campus. The school has 7 campus police officers. Officers are on duty Monday through Friday. Preventing a shooting begins with police being visible on campus.
We have a foot patrolling venue where we can get in comfortable with the people and talk to them and see what they're feeling, how they're feeling today. Know who's who on campus. Difficult because everybody carries a backpack. What do you have in that backpack is the key.
The school has a 12-member crisis response team that trains for various situations, including an active shooter on campus.
What are our options and what are our duties if something like that would happen here? So it's more of a inoculation of let's look at if that impacted Red Rocks, what would happen to us?
Getting a student mental health intervention is the latest training that police officers need.
When people are acting out in class, or employees, or and they're having a really bad day, or they haven't taken their medication, or whatever it may be, we get involved right away with trying to diffuse that to see if we can give them the resources to help them out.
The college is making behavioral intervention a higher priority by expanding the role of a mental health counselor from part-time to full-time. Another way the school is trying to prevent violent acts is with a new online reporting system called Maxient.
It is an incident reporting system, and we're really excited to have it because now the college community, any faculty, staff, or student at the college, if they see an incident, if they see anything that looks suspicious, they can go online. It will be accessed through our homepage, and there'll be a big clickable button that says report incident here, and it opens up a form that anybody can fill out that really talks about where they might have seen anything, what type of activity it was, when it was, and we also get the information of the person that's making the incident report so we can follow up on it.
In spite of all the preventive measures the police and school administration can implement to prevent a shooting on campus, what will they do if someone starts shooting? What should students, staff, and faculty do if that day comes?
Every month we go out to our shooting range and shoot. And we're very good. We have to be. We can't. That's one call you can't mess up.
If a person with a gun acts in a threatening manner, police will lock down the school. A public address system will broadcast a message to students, staff, and faculty with instructions to lock classroom doors with deadbolts and not come out until a police officer says so. Red Rocks has 47 doors. Main entryways are magnetically locked by a computer program, but side doors will have to be locked manually.
With the type of personnel I have here from a numbers standpoint only, I can't go around trying to put the threat down and then lock in all the doors. So it's better to stay in the classroom with the deadbolts and lock it down and stay there, stay away from the doorway.
Krause says everyone has a right to defend themselves and will be responsible for their safety.
Don't depend on the police department to be vigilant outside your office door for 16 hours a day. We can't do that. And also, it's tough for an officer to get around the whole building here in the college. So if you don't see a police officer for a couple of days, that's a good thing because there's nothing going on. That's why the police aren't there. If you have an active shooter here, you got 3 responses. Run, get out of here, hide, or fight. Now, you make that decision. I'm not making it for you.
If someone with a gun approaches the college, no one inside the school will probably see him or her coming because the school doesn't have surveillance cameras outside yet.
With the crime being so low here at the campus, from our efforts, it's hard to tell the powers that be that we need to spend a lot of money on cameras from that standpoint. I don't have metal detectors at all. It's a public building, open building, and that's why anybody can come in here.
Crime on campus is relatively low, mostly thefts of purses and laptops and car break-ins.
I'm very proud of the fact that we have a very safe campus, and that's why we have good enrollment. If it wasn't safe, people aren't coming here. We practice every month, and on active shooter scenarios, and we are well trained, and we know what our response will be, which will be basically put down the threat.